So I'm going to move on to some on-screen actions. So at this point, we have our environment set up and teardown taken care of. We have our basic navigation of opening and closing Notepad and getting the data that we need to test the application. So now that we've done that, you can see I have two more utilities created here. One is input test data. One is a utility to interact with the save dialog that appears. And one is to complete saving the data to a file. So again, we've kind of abstracted the actual logic of these. So the individual tests don't have to use this. It's really just building the data, putting together the building blocks to create the tests based off the utilities that are created in the framework. And as you can see, our get test data is being passed around through the different utilities. And it will basically, what's going to happen here is when we get the data, we assign certain things of the data that are our input steps. And so the utility here actually just loops through all of our input data and then does a verification if you want it to. And so this is what I was saying. If you need to add another column or more data to your input, you don't ever have to go update a single test. You just need to add a new line to your class for your test data object. Kind of same with the save dialog. We are abstracting the logic into the framework. So the main options are save, don't save, cancel, none. And so this allows, you know, say the dialog changes, say it's, you know, not a dialog, it's a new screen on the application or something like that. You can go and update these to just change it in one spot, and then all your tests that need to verify that something is saved, they still work again without having to worry about the logic. The framework handles the logic. And let's see, we don't have any verifications yet, but we do have a few more things added to our on-test start and on-test stop, because we are now starting to get to the point where we can actually save stuff, and we're going to move on to verifications. This is another part of environment setup and teardown. I make sure the path that we're going to save our results to is clean and empty, so we don't run into any overwrite errors or anything like that. I've also added a few extra utilities in here. It'll indent and outdent the log and add log folders for you, logging our return data from our test data, and added a few more things to our setup environment. And these are all still being used around everything else. So at this point, we can actually open up our smoke tests, and you'll be able to see that I have a few smoke tests created. So we have the verify open and close, verify inputs text correctly, and verify that you can save. And if you noticed, none of these have any individual recording. We're just calling the utilities and passing the data around.